Typically, I don't cover shows aimed at a very, very, very young age demographic, but for this show, I'll make an exception.
Every day when you're walking down the street.
Arthur is a PBS show based on the books by Mark Brown and has been running since 1996. It follows an aardvark without a nose, don't ask, named Arthur, who lives in Elwood City and shows the adventures of him and his friends. To say I grew up with this show would be an understatement. This was my childhood. I watched every single day before school. I had VHS tapes, toys of the characters. This show was all around our house. Here's my sister dancing to that library card episode. There are few shows that I can think of that defined me more than this one. And for good reason. It's a great show. It has good characters, doesn't talk down to its audience, goes into some mature topics sometimes, like Alzheimer's and cancer, and teaches good lessons. Usually. There is, of course, Arthur's big hit and DW's Very Bad Mood, which, well, meme-worthy, are pretty poor episodes.
But there is one episode that I think is worse than those two that doesn't get brought up as much, probably because it came out way later in the show's lifespan. And that is the 16th season episode, So Funny I Forgot to Laugh.
The episode starts with Sue Ellen writing in her diary about when she got a package from her Indian pen pal named
Tenzin Wangdu.
The package contained a sweater made of yak wool, which was nice of him, although it looks very itchy.
It felt magical, like I could almost feel the snow from the Himalayas around me.
Too bad it was actually 95 degrees and I passed out from heat stroke. Unfortunately, it seems something has happened that made her very sad. Well, despite my joke, it actually is snowing outside.
My ears are still frozen.
Buster, you might want to go to the nurse. That seems serious.
My friend Tenzin just sent me this. It's the warmest thing I've ever worn.
It's so warm I don't even need to wear long pants. Seriously, do you have the same leg-warming powers my dad has that makes it so you can wear shorts in the snow? Arthur makes a few jokes about the sweater, but they're mostly harmless and they all find them funny.
Hey! You left your backpack behind! Bad dog!
Yeah, thanks, Arthur. You're the comedic legend of our time. And the jokes keep getting worse, from calling her like she's a dog to calling her a good girl.
Who's a good sheepdoggy? You're a good sheepdoggy.
Sue Ellen politely tells them to stop, and this is when any excuse Arthur has stops. So far, she seemed to be finding the jokes funny, and now she wants him to stop. He better stop.
After all, Arthur wouldn't ruthlessly bully someone, would he?
I saw Capri Devapita wearing something just like that at a fashion show.
Are you sure it was a fashion show and not a dog show? Okay, I'll stop. I don't know why, it just cracks me up.
Yeah, saying the same joke over and over again is exactly how comedy works.
Here, why don't you have my biscuit?
Dude, I think you're pathetic, and I'm a 27-year-old man spending his Friday talking about a PBS cartoon.
So the next day at school, oh my god.
Happy Sheepdog Appreciation Day?
Alright, this episode is just making Arthur completely hateable. I know I'm not supposed to like his actions, but this is something I expect out of the bully characters like Binky or one of the other tough customers. Sue Ellen yells at him, saying she doesn't find it funny anymore.
Oh, that's great! Look, everyone! It's a picture of Fern as a goat!
Okay, I know Binky's not the brightest, but really?
Mr. Ratburn tells Arthur to stop teasing Sue Ellen, but he tries to defend himself, saying it was just a joke. There's a decent message in here about how joking about someone after they told you to stop is teasing and bullying, but it's done with the wrong character.
But imagine if someone made you feel bad for what you wore.
Alright, I can't take it anymore. Y'all remember what the very first episode of the show was? Arthur's eyes?
Yeah, in that episode, Arthur was teased by Francine about his glasses and he really didn't like it. Hell, the very first Arthur book was Arthur's Nose, about Arthur being teased about the length of his nose. So both the beginning of the books and the show were about Arthur being bullied and joked about. And yet for some reason, he's the bully now? This is not the right character to use for this story. Anyway, Ratburn says Arthur has to write an apology letter to Sue Ellen.
Don't take it out on the crackers. It's not their fault.
I think she should be the one apologizing to me.
Hey, Four Eyes, just write the stupid letter.
How do you figure that?
She didn't have to go to Mr. Ratburn. She could have just told me to stop.
Binky, Muffy, the Tibble twins, any of these characters would have worked for this message. Look, I understand being upset because you got punished for doing something you think is harmless, but Arthur isn't this thick.
I'm sorry I upset you. I didn't mean to. It was really just a joke. I thought you could take a joke, but I guess I was wrong.
Arthur's gonna spend his entire teen years being an alt-right reactionary on YouTube, isn't he? Oh, and they didn't just forget about the glasses thing. He brings it up and uses it to make her feel bad. This is not the same character I saw when I was 3. When Francine and Muffy read it, they decide not to speak to him until he gives her a real apology.
Oh my god, it's another episode that predicted cancel culture, and I thought anger management was bad.
It also accidentally shows why canceling doesn't work. You can't get someone to change if you don't speak to them to let them know what they did wrong. Thankfully, Buster is thick enough to tell him as he tries to apologize.
Do you still think I overreacted?
Well...
Sorry.
This episode feels so long, and it's only 11 minutes.
I'll admit I did laugh at the part where Arthur calls Buster and he tries to pretend he's not there, but then he decides to send a Photoshop picture of a sheepdog on top of Sue Ellen's body because now he's a cyberbully. Look, I know Arthur's not perfect, but this is not the character I grew up with. So Sue Ellen decides to donate the sweater, and now it seems Arthur is forced to sit with the tough customers, which... is a little funny, I guess? But I'm not 100% sure it's supposed to be funny. Oh, and Sue Ellen's switching classes.
We came to yell at you for making Sue Ellen ask to switch classes!
What? Because of me?
Of course! She doesn't want to be in a class with a bully!
Oh, you're one to talk. In fact, both of you have been bullies at some point, so shut up!
Arthur tries to stop her, but she goes home in the middle of the day for... reasons, and realizing what a jerk he's been, he offers an actual apology, and even says he's willing to wear the sweater for the rest of the year. Which, since he's using that as a self-punishment, still sounds like he's saying the sweater is ugly.
Deal. But I think I'll take my sweater back.
It really is the warmest thing I've ever worn.
And soft, right? Although it does kind of make you look like a big mouse.
Squeak, squeak, squeak.
And now Sue Ellen gets to be the bully. This episode sucks.
I get what the episode's going for, and with another character, it could have worked. I like the idea of starting out like you're just telling a joke, but it escalates into bullying. And when someone tells you to stop, you feel like they're being too sensitive. I get that. But Arthur isn't the character to tell that message, given that he's been bullied in the past and should know better. It's just uncomfortable to watch. The comedy isn't funny and makes me feel less like I learned a lesson and more like I just learned that even the most nice characters can be the biggest jerks for no reason. But like I said, the show is great. I grew up with it and it's still airing to this day, teaching kids lessons and entertaining them with these classic characters.
Man, this show has been going on for 24 years. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.